game.
So sick of having to clean up the mess down here.
I'm giving you 5 seconds to drop the weapon.
I need some new gear.
I didn't do anything to you.
Put your hands up!
You aren't helping your case.
Weapons now!
Sniper team, are you in position?
Roger, Sergeant. Man, it's cold. Why they gotta take us out to these cold places? I don't know. I've been up here in the mountains the entire time. Everyone thinks I'm sweating in the desert. Relatives keep sending me care packages with sunblock. Gee, thanks, Aunt Shirley. Yeah? Maybe I should use that to get moved around somewhere pleasant.
Roger. Maybe we can get a visual on the shooter, too. Hang in there, Bravo. All right. 360-degree security as we cross. Everyone turn out and watch your sectors. Go. Looks clear, but watch your flanks.
Action right. You take it!
Mouth shut and stick with me, all right?
Gotta be kidding.
shut and stick with me, all right?
Okay. I'll do what you say.
I'm counting on you.
Hey, you want some of this?
Hey, amigo.
You joking, right?
Hey, amigo.
Please, that's all I got, man, for real.
Quit running, pendejo.
Serves you right.
These are already turning. I've got some of my best soldiers on the case. It's all going according to plan.
If you're looking for a fight, bring it on.
I don't want no more hard luck cases on the streets, man. No more sad kids.
If somebody did follow me, it'd be your fault. Don't worry, this mission's no problema.
You gotta do what you gotta do to win, right? You're better than I thought.
The Norseland. They'll surely join us against the Aztec hordes.
We need to build a town here, though. We need the tribe to grow. First, let's look at the Norse. Hey, seems they have a leader.
Concentrate, and your godly powers will often let you hear his thoughts.
What? Greeks on my homeland?
but I saw them all die at the hands of the Aztecs.
Leader, if we build up an impressive enough town, these Norse will flock to join us.
Or if we build a big army, we can hunt them down and put them to the sword.
The Greeks must be stamped out before there are too many to count. They are a plague. Their city overflows.
To be a god, to wield the power of good and evil, that is your destiny.
Right here.
Baby, right this way. Hey, you got all your teeth there? You want to call timeout? Take a look.
Chucks it downfield. And it's...
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Vince Zampella. I'm the Chief Creative Officer over at Infinity Ward. Today we're going to be talking about the sequel to the award-winning Call of Duty. It's Call of Duty 2 for the Xbox 360. Call of Duty 2 picks up where the last one left off. It's a World War II first-person shooter. It puts you in the trenches with the guys who made the difference in the epic cinematic intensity of war, the battles that made the difference. You're in with the squads, the guys in the trenches that really made the difference, that turned the tides of war. Call of Duty 2 really has a unique aspect in its squad gameplay. It's all about you working together with a squad of soldiers to make a difference in the battle. They tell you about situations going on around you. They tell you if there's an enemy flanking you from the left. They tell you what's going on, if they need to reload, if they need, it's a communication of war and what's going on in the fight around you. We've been in simultaneous development on both versions of the game, the PC and the next generation Xbox, for the entire time. We're really focusing the Xbox version on the console gameplay, the controls. It really comes out, you know, the differences are in the high def audio, high def visuals. You know, it makes a huge difference in the look and feel of the game, capitalizing on the end user's high end hardware that they'll generally have in their living room for their home audio system. We can't go into too much specifics right now on the differences, like, you know, the high def visuals, high def audio. There will be differences between the PC and the next generation Xbox game to separate the two. One of the biggest advantages of working with the next gen Xbox hardware is the high definition widescreen resolution that we run at. It really allows you to see, you know, more of what's going on in the game, and it allows you to see things more immersively. It draws you in, everything looks more crisp, more real, so much more detail to be seen. On the next generation of hardware, the difference in processing power allows us a whole new level of AI and characters on screen. One of the things that, you know, games always suffer from is, you know, how many characters can you get on screen before things fall apart, and it really kind of sets the stage for the game, especially in a war game, where that squad behavior and you have so much more going on, so much more around you. So we're really maximizing what we can do with each system, you know, specific to the platform. So the owners of next generation Xbox hardware really have a lot to look forward to, specific to their platform. Call of Duty 2 will be out holiday 2005 for the PC and Xbox 360.
Pressure on them, boys!
Let's go!
Die!
Take a look at the fire over here!
happily here. Sweet smoke, these Moroccan cigars.
Wilson! Wilson! Moccasin here!
Moccasin, use my code name.
Moonshiner! There's a moccasin! It's dark! They're all alone! This Billy's tank is on fire!
You've got to charge a moccasin. Their gun's got longer range.
Their new tank! I watched my shells bounce back!
Keep going! Keep mobile!
Murphy's dead! Carter jumped out and he got mowed down! Our right track's knocked out! We're sitting ducks here! I'm gonna...
Moccasin! Moccasin! Do you read me, dammit? Button up, boys. Cigar burn later. Let's move it. Krauts ain't pushovers. Everything is going as planned. Come on, keep moving. I have to get there. Come on, keep moving. Let's go. Come on, keep moving. Come on, keep moving. How far is it? I'm not supposed to stop. I'm not supposed to stop.
Hier, Herr Kommandant.
Wer tot soll euch holen?
Der Weg ist blockiert.
Thank you.
This game has not yet been rated.
Condemned is a psychological thriller for the Xbox 360 and for the PC. You're Ethan Thomas, a member of the Serial Crimes Unit, hunting down serial killers, and you're trying to clear your name and prove your innocence. Classifying the game is really interesting. It's not a first-person shooter, it's not a survival horror game. We're calling it a psychological thriller. It's first-person action with forensic elements and also has some scary, terrorizing moments built in as well. Talking about the game structure, how the game is structured, you start at the beginning, you learn a little bit of background and you learn how to use your forensic tools, but you're quickly thrown into the story and you get into a moment from being a qualified high member, a detective of the FBI, to being a rogue agent trying to prove your innocence. And you go through different elements, different parts of the city, from metro station, the low subway area, to some really creepy moments in an abandoned department store and old burnt library as well. And taking advantage of the Xbox 360 hardware is very important. We're supporting high def support, so the game's going to be able to run in 720p high def, It also currently supports 480p as well. We have beautiful graphics. You look through the world and the textures are very detailed. We actually went to real life locations and took pictures of real life locations. And those textures were put into the world with normal mapping. So as you walk up to them, they actually appear to be 3D and detailed and have height to them. And also, we're supporting Xbox Live Community. Even though it's a single player game, there's extra features that we'll have that take advantage of that were not available before on Xbox. We are supporting the achievement system, the gamer card, and like when you're online, your friends will actually be able to see you playing the game and not only know you're playing Condemned, but they'll know you have the pipe in your hand and you're fighting two addicts and just battling it out right then and there. Setting mood with the lighting is a really cool part of the game as well. We have volumetric lighting, so as you're walking around, you come into a room. There's one really good example in our demo right now. As you walk in, there's light spilling into this dark room, and as you get to different parts, there's more levels of light. And light also is important because when you see little bits of movement in the distance, and you see shadows, and you see doors open, it's so scary. It just really builds to the tension and scariness of the game. Audio is a very important issue, especially with this type of game. Monolith did a great job. They have a sound designer named Brian on board at Monolith, who his whole job is making great sounds and music and really building the environment. And so when you go through, the sound you get, like when you hit someone on the head with a pipe, that crunch noise is just unbelievable. Or when you pick up a shovel, the twang you get, oh, it's really cool. And then the background ambient music, I mean, it's just, you know, when you're going through and the music's building up and you know people are there but you don't know where they are, oh, it just builds it up and it makes that experience that much more intense. One really cool feature about the game is the forensic tools. This really has not been seen in other games. So, you know, you're a member of the Serial Crimes Unit and you're a detective, so a big part of it is finding clues and going out and searching around, and you'll have a variety of tools available to use. One of them we have is this green laser detection tool. So as you go around and you look on the floor, it can actually detect elements and trace elements of evidence. So like if you find some developer fluid on the floor, you look, and if you just look with the naked eye, you couldn't see it. But if you pull out the tool, you highlight it over it and suddenly the evidence shows up. And so you're collecting this evidence and using it, and you actually have mind's eye moments during the game that where your characters piece together the moments and giving you, the player, more information about where to go with the story and helps push you through. It's really cool. Condemned Criminal Origins is coming out. It's been announced that it's coming out holiday 2005 for the Xbox 360. It will also be coming out for the PC at a later date. We haven't announced when, and that's when it's coming. Ugh.
Receiving data. Blood types a match with Tippett's. However, the partial print could belong to our killer.
Oh! Pig.
Last time I saw a car like that. Bad sight.
This is coming black. You must be a lightning whack or something. I'll send you a postcard! Ah, this is gonna work! Say is, it's a good thing you're cute.
This is burning!
Anybody want to train cars?
We call that the hammer dancers. That's the 357 out of feds want us. Cause we led dumping head hunters. Bar with every hood, all is limelight. A G ain't nothing but a letter you can hang, man.
Thank you.
Hop on that turret.
Win back your soul? I'll give you the soldiers. I'll give you the bullets.
Day one. The day I came here was the worst day of my life. I'll admit it, it was a big mistake. I'm a wartime photojournalist. I've seen it all. Horror, famine, death. The real stuff of nightmares. At least, that's what I thought. That was until I saw a corpse get up, walk, and kill. You probably think I'm nuts. The dead getting up and walking? Zombies. I'm not nuts, though. Right now, if things go well, I may get my hands on a Pulitzer or something. It's not like you hear about too many zombie stories in the news these days. So I guess there are only two things left to do. Film everything I can, and survive until help arrives.
The end of days will soon be upon us. What is thy bidding?
I have summoned you to wreak vengeance.
There will be no escape for the innocent.
Kill all of them.
No forgiveness for the guilty.
And I want them to suffer.
And no mercy shown to mankind.
Make them suffer.
ここの方が楽にしねえぞ。信長様、もう持ちません。敵だ、敵役だぞ。死守せよ。門を抜かせるのはよ。とぼけが、やべえ、こりゃまずい。
信長様、もう持ちません。生きた心地がしません。敵に囲まれた。マジ救すか。
だがこれ以上は進ませぬ。騎馬隊がよ、味わい。できる。 だがこれ以上は進ません。奉行に上昇なく月に支障を。
さあ、これからがパーティーってやつだ。<笑><笑>
こともなし。
貴の虎が現せるわ。虫けらは。
たわけが。
おめえはオラに勝てねえ。
ショーの始まりだ。レディー、ファイト！ギア！
I am the voice of the flame. I am the voice of the flame.
For 65 years, I have ruled this empire. Generals and kings have knelt at my command. But a darkness comes. The blood tide rises. These are the closing days of the Third Era. And the final hours of my life. Close shut the jaws of oblivion.
Okay.
You're ready?
Yes, let's go.
Where is he? Time is running out.
Hurry.
What's so funny? Hey, you too, mister.
Hi.
How's it going out there?
target in sight, all according to plan. So boring.
Okay, let's switch to our plan.
Roger. We'll go in, but keep an eye on us, okay?
And go! Your legs. Good, keep going. Okay, let's focus on increasing that intensity now. Use your legs to get any low ones when you can. Well done! Leave nothing standing. Nice save! Punch, punch, jab. Great work.
Round two. Fight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Negative. Must have been a shadow.
What's that?
Nothing. I have the visual on the intruder. I've lost the visual on the intruder.
The photo that she took was of her ex-lover. Who is dead. Rei Kurosawa, who's been missing her lover since his death.
You met him, Lee.
Entering into the nightmare. Miku Hinasaki. She thought she lost power along with her brother that day. But the power has returned, and it comes back to her now.
Mata, kono yume. Mou minakunatta to omotta no ni.
Kei Amakura. He seeks the truth concealed within.
Yume? Nano ka? Doko ni iru nda? Minu.
The ghosts trapped in this mansion will hunt our heroes down. A life that knows peace, nevermore. This is a nightmare that never ends. As the sadness, pain, and curse covers every inch of the body, from a place no one can escape. Fatal Frame 3. The Tormented. Coming this fall, 2005, for PlayStation 2.
Thank you. Fear is a basic human emotion. What frightens you more? The evil that you know? Or the evil that you don't know?
アルケイディア軍のダルマスカ侵攻を妨げるものは何もありません。奴らが国境に達するのは時間の問題です。
ガルテアの壁をそなた。
ありがたき幸せ。
With the threat of all-out war on the horizon, the Arcadian Empire.Invades and subjugates its neighboring kingdoms one by one. Dalmasca, the stage on which this tale is set, is one such kingdom.
さあ、坊主。観念してそいつを俺に渡すんだ。
してないとしたか。
ダマナスタ市民諸君、帝国が憎いか、この私を憎んでいるか。 えることなく憎しみを受け止め背負い、そしてダルマスカを守ろう。
まだだ、まだ魔法障壁がある。
これは私の償いである。
ラスラ様。
The story of an age when magic was commonplace and airships plied the skies, crowding out the heavens. Final Fantasy XII.
My name is Alan Averill, and I am a writer with the Nintendo Treehouse Department. Battalion Wars is a real-time strategy game, but it has a lot of action elements to it. So the team, Kuju, out of England, has done a really nice job of blending those two things together, and you'll be able to get your hands on it and see how that works. It looks like a third-person action game. But it, in many ways, controls like a real-time strategy game. There have not been a lot of real-time strategy games for console systems. It's just tough to pull off. You know, with the PC, you have a mouse, you have a keyboard, you have a lot more control. So with the exception of a few things like Goblin Commander, the Pikmin series, it's not something that you've seen a lot. And one of the things we've been able to do with Battalion Wars is to translate the control of a real-time strategy game over to a console experience. So you'll be able to individually take control of units, and there are you know, dozens of units in this game, everything from foot soldiers to flamethrower units to planes, tanks, guys with rocket launchers, about everything you can imagine. And you can take control of one at a time individually on the battlefield at any time you want. And while you control them, you can also send your units to other places. If you want to post infantry over here, send the tanks over here, you can do that. And it's all with just a button press. You know, one button press gathers everybody together, one button press sends them all away. The basic story of the game takes place. There's a battle between two different countries, the Tundra and the Western Frontier. And as they fight pretty much to a standstill, a third country called Exylvania comes on the scene and starts fighting both countries and basically pushes them to the limit. So it's the story of how you unite the frontier and the tundra and get them to push back the Exylvanian threat. So you will fight in all three countries, plus a couple of other additional places. There's forests, there's deserts, there's one level where you storm a beach, which is really cool. You know, just planes and stuff flying overhead. There's, you know, old castles that you have to storm. It's a very unique experience with a lot of different areas to play around in. Battalion Wars will be coming out later this year, and it's only going to be available on the Nintendo GameCube.
Take that, fool. on, do something!